the water. You need to put it in warm water. The water is too hot, it's gonna die. The water is too cold, it's not gonna flower. Now it's very important that when you make the yeast, you put the warm water, you test it with your with the back of your finger. It should be warm, but you know you should be able to comfortably keep it in there.
I'll show you how to make plain bread, but...
sweetest bread tastes good with the palyavar, so we're going to mix it. You mix it lightly, then you add oil, which you're going to do. Now, to reduce the amount of oil used in the bread and also to give it a little more fluff, we're going to do some flaxseed powder. So we're going to do 2 tablespoons of flaxseed powder, and then we're going to add oil. So we'll be putting less oil. So flaxseed powder is also healthy and, you know, it gives it like a nice texture. So mix flaxseed powder. Flaxseed powder. You can buy whole flaxseed and grind it at home. You just have to visit. That's all. There's nothing else that's required. Okay. Sorry? Yeah. You can all see. This is the dry ingredients all mixed together nicely. To this you add the oil and you mix it a bit. So rub it in. So we will be putting only 3 tablespoons of oil, not more than that. Another little trick which I have seen is I learned this through another of my fellow bloggers who sent the idea. Add 1 tablespoon of vinegar. This is the thing. Sourdough bread. They make sourdough bread by letting it ferment for a while and then mixing it, giving it a long rise. So the sourness of it actually helps the bread rise nicely, a lot more. So that's the same thing. Vinegar does that, helps to make it more fluffy. So you can skip it if you want, but it benefits to add 1 tablespoon of which we're dumpsters. So once you've added the oil, mix it into the flour. So let it form some crumbs and mix it nicely into the flour. Just 1 tablespoon will do, otherwise you may get some. Mix that up. See, it's going to start forming, light crumbs like this. Surface and then knead it. folded.
Yes.
If you do it with your fingers like this, it tends to get sticky and stuff. This will add a lot. You know, you're adding layers also into it while you're doing it. That's the tenfold press. So that's a good way to read it. Like the oil above. You can generously oil it too if you want. Add your ball of dough all around, coat it with oil so that it gets nicely coated. Then take a large plastic cover, put the whole ball into it, close it, keep it. You need it to rise for 2 hours minimum. That's a minimum amount of time. But don't let it go beyond maybe, you know, about 3.5 hours to 4. Not beyond that, because then again it's not very nice for the Okay. Now variations to this. You can mix. You can mix any like ingredients like spices, cinnamon, those kind of things into the. If it's a very spicy, if it's cinnamon or ginger which tends to have a stronger flavor, limit it when you're mixing it into the dough, then add later. But if it's things like, I make this khara bread, like most people, if you grew up like eating bread at bakeries, local bakeries, small local bakeries, they had these breads with onion and lot of herbs and cilantro and all that. That tastes really nice, comes out more fluffy also. In the kneading step, before you start adding the liquid ingredients, add all your chopped onion, chopped herbs, all the your crushed chili, all those things. Add it, then add your liquid and then mix it and then. You can also add grated vegetables into it. In which case the liquid ingredients will drastically reduce. You probably won't even need that extra 1 cup of the water or coconut. And for those friends, just use water. That should do. You know, you don't really need coconut milk. And there is another thing also which you do. It's make it plain like this. And then you stuff it. This is what we're gonna do. Yeah. So you saw, all of you saw the dough. After 2 hours, this is how much it rises. So it's supposed to rise like this. If your dough hasn't risen, you're not gonna get bread out of it. Just make chapati and do it. That's it. So it is important for it to rise like this. Then once it has risen like this, you just beat it out like this. You shouldn't need a lot at this point. Okay? Beat it out. See, there are some bubbles and it's more soft and elastic, more resin like this. This can be turned into buns, it can be turned into a loaf, no problem. A loaf would need a longer rising time as well as a longer baking time. Buns, much lesser time, you can just put it and it cooks quite easily. So as I said, don't need it a lot, just a little bit, plant a bit. You make it into little balls like this, plant in it. So today what we have is a potato mixture, which is your standard palya bun from bakeries, what you put for masala dosa. We'll show you how to make that also, which is simple. Most of you probably know, but anyway, we'll show you that. So you stretch it out like this. Just fold it. So these were slightly bigger than this, but it was just a sample. You can do that. And you put it on a tray like this. Once you put it on a tray like this, cover it with a moist cloth. Or again, at home you're all going to have smaller OTGs, you're going to have plastic bag. That's what I do. I just put it and then I put my tray into the plastic bag. You can do it on a flat cookie tray or you can even do it in a cake tray. They'll all kind of stick to each other, but that's nice in a different way. So you let it rise for a minimum of 1 hour for the buns. For the loaf, you let it rise for at least 1.5 hours. So after making the balls like this, yes. First is 2 hours and then the second rise is 1 hour. So 1 hour is very important. So see, the longer you let it rise, the fluffier it will be. Keep it in a slightly sunny spot or somewhere where it's a little warm. That's the reason you need to cover it properly with either the plastic cover or the moist cloth, because otherwise it's gonna dry on top and then it's not gonna rise properly. So it has to be covered. And what happens when you cover it, especially with the plastic bag, is the heat gets retained inside. So that helps, it forms a little oven of its own and it rises nicely. So these were about half the size of it, and this has been rising now for
1 hour.
So it's become about this big. Now the next step is oven. You need to preheat your oven to 190 degrees. This for the loaf, you need it to be higher. For a loaf, you need it to be slightly higher, about 200. For buns, about 190 degrees. Keep it in the oven and you bake. You bake these buns for about 35 to 40 minutes. If you have made it with maida, then you need to bake for a lesser amount of time. Maybe about 25 minutes and that's about it. But since you're making it with whole wheat, everything increases. Your rising time increases and your baking time increases. Otherwise, it gets doughy.